Hello, my dear children and parents. Welcome to class 8th of Indus Valley Public School, Rat, where we were doing lesson number 5, The Summit Within, written by HPS Ahluwalia. Children, in this video, in the last video, we already studied about some of the points. Let's see what we have studied. Key points were there. The author HPS Ahluwalia has narrated his experience of climbing the summit of Everest. As the author stood on the summit, many emotions surged through him. All the emotions, the dominant one was humility. Humility means down to earth, very polite. Climbing the summit of Everest provides a deep sense of joy which lasts a lifetime and changes the climber completely. According to the author, there is another summit, the summit of mind, that is more difficult to climb. After getting down from the summit, the author questioned himself as to why people climb mountain. It was a question. And we got general answers also in the textbook while we were reading it. Now children, here, why people climb the mountain? Man takes delight in overcoming obstacles. It presents great difficulties. Mountains are a mean of communion, or you can say communication with God. There are three qualities that played a major role in climbing mountain: endurance, persistence, and willpower. That means determination, continuation, and your inner power. Now, climbing is adventure and risky, but pleasurable. Why? See, it is a brutal struggle with rock and rise. That means it is a very tough struggle with rock and ice, because we face all these things while climbing the mountain. It gives a sense of battle fought and won. Obviously, when you are on the top, you will see you have fought a battle and you won it, and it will give you immense pleasure in it. It provides physical, emotional, and spiritual experience. How? Physical, because your body is working on that, you are climbing. Then emotions, because sometimes you feel like to come down, then somehow you get you get motivated from your friends, something like that. Then you get we will climb. And spiritual, that is your inner inspiration, your soul that said, no, I have to do it. So these all things, physical, emotional, and spiritual, these emotions come across while climbing any kind of summit. Now, we have also seen, along with HPS Ahluwalia, there were three more people. They were Vinod Rawat, Emmett Hillary, Fuji Dorji, and they have kept symbol of reverence. Okay, and what were they? They were Guru Nanak, then cross, Goddess Durga, and Lord Buddha. Okay, these were the reverences they kept on the mountain in order to show their gratitude, in order to show their respect to the God as they safely reach to the summit of the mountain. Now, the conclusion of the lesson was, there is another summit that is in your own mind. The physical act of climbing to the summit of mountain outside is akin to the act of climbing mountain within. It teaches us much about the world, about ourselves, both the thing. Okay, until and unless you are not knowing yourself, you are not going to do the particular thing. So it teaches us about knowing ourselves as well as knowing the world. It provides us the inspiration to face life's ordeals and determination. Ordeals means difficulties. Okay, so this is the conclusion of the lesson. So, whole what you have studied in the lesson, I have just briefed out you. Now, coming to the summary of the lesson. Now, summary. Major H.P.S. Ahluwalia was a member of the first successful Indian expedition to Mount Everest in 1965. In the lesson, he tells us he felt as he stood on the Everest. So now here, H.P.S. Ahluwalia sharing his personal experience of climbing the Everest. Standing on Everest, Major Ahluwalia felt very humble. Physically, he was very tired. Instead of being very happy, he was jubilant and sad. He was not sure of the reason why he was sad. He wondered if his sadness was because now there was no higher peak to climb. Ahluwalia says that after climbing Everest, he felt a deep sense of joy. This joy was to last the rest of his life. He also felt thankful to God. Ahluwalia had climbed a summit, but he thought of another summit. So once he was there, and he started thinking for another summit. This was the summit of mind. He came to the conclusion that in order to climb a summit, a person needed three qualities. What are the three qualities? Endurance, persistence, and willpower. It is only with the help of these qualities that a man overcomes obstacles. The climbing of a summit is thus a demonstration of these three qualities. That is why men take delight in overcoming obstacles. Ahluwalia says that a question arises: why he chose to climb Mount Everest? He says that the first reason is that he has always loved mountains. Everest is the highest and the mightiest of them all. It is a great struggle against rock and ice. So, after climbing this summit, there is a joy of having done something which only a few can do. Looking at the peak from a distance, Ahluwalia is transported to another world. He has a mystical feeling. In fact, the difficulties of climbing Everest are huge, but this is what attracts him to it. It is a challenge that he finds difficult to resist. Ahluwalia says that the call to face the challenge of overcoming the obstacles was irresistible. That means alluring or tempting. Next, climbing Everest is not just a physical achievement or conquest. It brings fulfillment and fame. Besides, the experience is emotional and spiritual also. Climbing mountain also gives us lesson in comradeship, that means companionship, friendship. While climbing, two person have to share a rope. One climber holds the rope firmly while the other climbers cut the step in the hard ice. Then he belays and the other climber inches his way up. Famous climbers have left records of the help given by others. A single man cannot simply think of being a climber. It's not only the physical difficulties which will deter him, the difficulties and emotion too. In all those moments, the comrades draw inspiration from each other. Looking down from Everest, the climber feels that the efforts was worthwhile. It is an ennobling experience. The climber bows down to God in order to show respect and gratitude. Ahluwalia left on Everest a picture of Guru Nanak. Rawat left a picture of Goddess Durga. Fudorji left a relic of Buddha. Emmett Hillary had buried a cross under the cane in the snow. These are all symbols not of conquest but of reverence. That means unki jeet ke symbol nahi the, but these are the symbols of their gratitude and respect towards the God. each man has within him his own mountain peak. It is fearful and unscalable. Yet no one else but the man has to do it himself. Climbing this inside peak is like climbing Everest too. The effects are the same. Both the climbs change you. The internal summit is perhaps higher than Everest. So my dear children, this is your summary. Now coming to your book's exercise comprehension, check first question. Standing on Everest, the writer was overjoyed, very sad, or jubilant and sad? So answer is jubilant and sad. The emotions that gripped him was what? Victory over hurdles, humility and the sense of smallness, greatness and self-importance, joy of discovery. So answer is humility and a sense of smallness. The summit of mind refers to, so you have to mark the item that is not relevant, that is not to the answer. Okay, so now check the options. Great in intellectual achievement, the process of maturing mentally and spiritually, overcoming personal ambition for wealth welfare, for common welfare, living in the world of thought and imagination, the triumph of mind over worldly pleasure for a noble cause, a fuller knowledge of oneself. So correct answer is the great intellectual achievement. Now coming to the question answers of the lesson, answer the following questions. First question, what are the three qualities that played a major role in the author's climb? So three qualities that played a major role in his climb are endurance, persistence and willpower. Why is adventure, why is risky also pleasurable? An adventure presents great obstacle to the man. It is human nature to endure all pains to cross those obstacles. It provides physical, emotional and spiritual experience. It is always risky. It results in victory and a sense of fulfillment. Therefore, it is pleasurable since it changes the adventurer. Question number 3. What was it about Mount Everest that the author found irresistible? Author was always fond of mountain climbing. Mount Everest is the highest, the mightiest, and has defied many previous attempts. It takes the last ounce of one's energy. It is a brutal struggle with rock and ice. The passage up and down is difficult. Its climb gives one the sense of victory. Therefore, the author found it irresistible on account of its challenge and difficulties. Next question. One does not do it, that means climb a high peak, for fame alone. What does one do it for, really? One does not climb a high peak for a fame alone. On the other hand, the sense of fulfillment and eternal love for adventure in man urge a climber to do it. Reaching a peak means witnessing the communion with the God. Next question. He becomes conscious in a special manner of his own smallness in this large universe. This awareness defines an emotion mentioned in the first paragraph. Which is the emotion? The emotion mentioned is humility. It means a sense of being small and mortal. What was the symbol of reverence left by member of team on Everest? The member of team left the following symbol of reverence on the Everest to make the air obeisance to God. The author left a picture of Guru Nanak. Rawat left the picture of Goddess Durga. Fudoji left a relic of Buddha. Emmett Hillary had buried a cross under a heap of rock and stones in the ice. Next, what, according to the writer, did his experience as an Everester teach him? The act of climbing the Everest taught the author to face life's ordeals resolutely and to conquer another summit that is within the mind. It is fearful and unscalable. One must climb it to see fuller knowledge of oneself. Now children, this question you will be doing by yourself. I'll explain you one example and rest you will do by yourself. Okay? So write a sentence against each of the following statement. Your sentence should explain the statement. You can pick out sentence from the text and rewrite them. The first one has done for you and rest you will do by yourself. The experience changes you completely. So which line explain this feeling? One who has been to the mountain is never the same again. Okay. Similarly, other question you will be doing. Questions are, man takes delight in overcoming obstacles. Mountain are nature's at its best. The going was difficult, but the after effect was satisfying. The physical conquest of a mountain is really a spiritual experience. Okay. Now here, working with the language. So write down the noun form of the following words, adding A-N-C-E or E-N-C-E to each. Do it yourself. Two examples I've already done. Endurance. So A-N-C-E you are going to add. Persist to persistence. E-N-C-E. So similarly, you will be adding other also and you will complete noun to which form? You have to write down the noun form from these words. Okay. Now match the word meanings. Words are remote, means dominant, formidable, overwhelmed, difficult to overcome, most prominent, be overcome or overpowered, method, far reach. So you will match the word meanings and then what you need to do in question number 3, from column number A, you will choose the word and you will fill in the blanks here. Because you will, in question number 2, you will be able to find out the meaning of the particular word and then read through the sentences and fill the option given there. Okay. So first blank. There were dash obstacles on the way, but we reached our destination. We have no dash of finding out what happened there. Why he lives in a house dash from any town or village is more than I can tell. Dash my gratitude. We owe a boat to the speaker for his valuable advice. The old castle stand in a dash position above the sleepy town. So these are the things that you have to complete by yourself. Three questions are there that you need to do. So complete your work, complete your exercise, question, answers and summary. Any doubt, please do call me up. Okay. Till then, bye bye and take care. Thank you so much.